Welcome to DTU Skylab. DTU Skylab is an innovation hub located at the Technical University of Denmark. We are an open learning environment where we focus on fostering entrepreneurial mindsets, but also providing students with the right toolset and skill set to actually turn the academic knowledge into value in society. We have project rooms, meeting rooms, and auditorium, like classic learning facilities. But we also have different kind of prototyping workshops and labs. We have welding, we have metal workshop, wood workshop, sheet metal. We have 3D printers, laser cutters. We have a small electronic lab. We have a wet lab, and we're opening a new food lab.
Skylab is a really inspiring place where you can build, you can get help, you can get this collaboration with the companies.
Every time we need to do something new, they'll teach us how to do stuff so we can do it ourselves the next time.
There's a lot of tools and there's a lot of possibilities for us for prototyping, which is a major part of our work.
What is really unique about Skylab is that we combine a learning environment with a makerspace. We try to engage all the stakeholders in the ecosystem and invite them in an open approach, but it's all a learning facility for our students. The Technical University of Denmark is a technical university of all of Denmark located in Copenhagen. We have sciences going all the way from energy sciences, mechanical sciences, chemical sciences, life engineering sciences, so we have a very wide spread.
The ecosystem at DTU is very unique in the sense it takes student education, state-of-the-art technology research, and innovation from within companies all together to co-develop solutions that are more impacting on society and also more innovative in general. It means you can go a little bit beyond just learning how to do a job of work or learning how to solve technical problems, but more about analyzing what the value in solving your particular technical problem is. At DTU, I teach an innovation technology entrepreneurship course. The grounding behind this course is a technology. The students are then to understand that, to understand the virtues of where is it particularly outperforming its competition, and then to work out which marketplace would most benefit from this technology, and then to create a spin-out business based on that underlying technology.
Fire Eater is a manufacturer of fire extinguishing systems and components, and I was contacted by DTU. We have developed a completely new technology for smoke detection. They wanted some students to work a little bit with that.
We were given an e-nose, or an electric nose from Fire Eater, and we thought that we could use this in the fish industry.
Fission is an objective way of measuring the quality of the fish. Today you don't actually find that on the market, you only find the manoeuvre inspection, so this is like a whole new product.
You take the fish, you put it into the box, you run a test, and then you do a series of machine learning and different technologies, and then it will print a label that you can put on your fish, and then you sort of have a quality assessment. One of the most important things about the innovation and product development course was the sort of the group dimensions. Seeing how different people have their strengths and building on that, because that is super important in a startup when you are probably four or five people who's doing the entire job of a full company.
And another thing is that you are able to actually create the prototype in Skylab, and you have a lot of mentorship from every kind of person each week. So we are quite lucky.
I'm overwhelmed how they handled the project, being able to reach out, explain things, doing hardcore mathematics, visualizing, prototyping, the whole package from grasping this idea and then bringing it to life. I think it's an overwhelming experience.
The innovation-framed learning has been very successful for students. We can see that in our postgraduate surveys. We can also see it through that students are making much more solutions for companies while they study, and we see an increasing number of startups from students.
Relevant is a startup company founded in 2015. What we essentially do is that we have made a solution that reduces the joining time of high voltage power cables from 2 days to now we can do it in less than an hour.
Here at DTU, there have been a lot of focus on doing things yourself. And with Skylab, it opened up for a possibility where we could actually do prototype iteration ourselves with a strong backup from the crew here in Skylab.
There's also funding. We have been able to have funds, or they have helped us get the grants from different foundations.
We gained a lot of skills here from DTU, and we have a strong background doing practical stuff. using laboratories, facilities, both at DTU Mechanical Institute and also DTU Electrical Institute.
And then combined with the entrepreneurial professors that really try to push students into the entrepreneurial thinking, we're really able to move forward.
We live in this time of radical change where we have the opportunity, like never before, to create a future that's much better. It could be significantly more sustainable, could be much more relevant for people, and create opportunities for everyone. If that is your mindset, you need to be open-minded to work with other people with different skills. You need to be able to collaborate in new ways, and you need to be responsible in your approach so the solution you create improves society. You have all of that in one here at Skylab.
The new generation of engineers are much more holistic than they were when I became an engineer. Society is not something new for them when they get out there. They have actually been living with society in the ecosystem around the university. They know how technology can influence the world, and I'm sure that they will use that to benefit the world, to make the world a better place to be.